class. My name is Uche Martins. Welcome to Basic Science and Technology class. Today, we'll be treating the topic Rescue Operations Part 1 with the theme Safety. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to 1. Explain the meaning of rescue operations, identify different aspects of rescue operations, describe the steps involved in each aspect of what rescue operations. What is rescue operation? A rescue operation is any operation carried out to get people out of danger or a particular hazard going on. For instance, if a person or group of people in a house on fire, bringing them out to safety requires a process or a method known as rescue operation. So any operation you do to get people out of danger, it can be a collapsed building, that process is what we refer to as rescue operation. What is rescue operation? Rescue operation is an organized procedure used to bring a person or group of people out of danger, attack, or harm. Rescue operation involves saving lives and preventing what? Injuries. Some rescue operation aids used to bring out people out of danger includes rescue dog or horses. It can be jaw of life that is used in dismantling a broken car, hydraulic cuttings, helicopters, etc. There are 6 major aspects or phases of any rescue operation. These are response, evaluation, pre-entry, operations, removal, and terminations. These 6 aspects can be put together to give an acronym REPORT. REPORT, where R stands for your response, where E stands for your evaluation, your P stands for pre-entry, O for operations, R for removal, T for termination. What is response? Response during a rescue operation can be defined as the immediate reaction made by a rescue crew. Immediately, information of a particular hazard, maybe a collapsed building, a house on fire, the immediate reaction taken by these rescue operatives is what we call response. And it's an important phase in what? Rescue operation. This phase of rescue operation, it is divided into 2 parts, what we call the pre-dispatch phase and also the responding phase. What is pre-dispatch phase? In this phase, they gather information about the particular hazard or harm that has occurred. They find out if this hazard can be addressed by them or if they need extra help in addressing this hazard. They try to locate the location or the address in which this particular accident or hazard as well has occurred. So first, in the pre-dispatch phase of the response phase, what they do, they gather the necessary operational information, find out what hazard have occurred. If it's a situation of a vehicle accident, if it's a house on fire, if it's a collapsed building or a collapsed bridge, find out the nature and the address of the what area. Is it a slopy area? Is it a cave region? And also find out the resources available to address that impact. If they will be in need of a firefighting van, if they will be in need of cave or mountain climbers. These are some of the information gathered in the response phase of a rescue operation. Responding phase. In this phase, the rescue crew dispatches to the place of call. They must be aware of communication availability. Is there means of communication with other areas or there is no communication at all at that particular area? Now, the second stage or the second phase or aspect of rescue operation is what? Your evaluation. The difference between evaluation and response is, in response, it is not done on the field. It is done outside the field. It is, the information is gathered based on what they are being told. But for evaluation, evaluation of a rescue operation is the systematic assessment of the impact of the hazard. It is done on the scene of impact or hazard. Immediately they get to that area of hazard, maybe the collapsed building, the rescue crew conducts an initial approach assessment to determine the hazard and the type of emergency that will be needed in addressing that hazard. Also, they find out if there is need for any additional resources. The rescue crew should be able to ascertain the risks involved and the benefits. The rescue crew should be able to tell if it's a body recovery operation or a patient rescue operation. In evaluation, getting to the place where the hazard have occurred, they should be able to determine the risks and benefits. Is it worth it? Are we going for a body recovery or to rescue a patient? Those are important information that will be evaluated by the rescue crew during evaluation phase. Pre-entry. The pre-entry phase is the phase where the scene is made as safe as possible. In this phase, some steps like isolation, evacuation, and lockout are followed. Now, in pre-entry phase, when they've gotten to the place of hazard, they will make sure that it is safe. The rescue crew make sure that they carry out isolation. And isolation involves putting up caution marks, e.g. a police line mark of do not cross, to prevent entry of unauthorized personnel and the public. Evacuation. Maybe it's in the case of a fire accident, for instance. They evacuate the area involved. Simply involves the removal of unauthorized persons from the scene. Also, lockout. Lockout usually applies to emergency situation. It involves securing and isolating equipment from its energy source while rescue is taking place. First of all, in lockout, what they try to do is that it's mostly involved in what? Fire emergency, where they try to shut down the power source to prevent further spread of what? Electrical fire. The next stage is operation. Operation phase involves the main rescue of either the casualty or his or her body from the hazard. Like I said, the rescue operation is done based on the information obtained from the risk assessment or information. If it's worth it for the crew to go in to rescue the persons, to prevent further harm, if it's a body recovery operation or a patient emergency operation, or if it's a property recovery operation. This phase requires the operation of only qualified rescue personnel. Tools and other aids are used in this phase. The next is removal. Removal is an important phase in every rescue operation. Removal is a phase in a rescue operation which involves the safe and effective removal of victims from the danger zone, that is, the place where this hazard has occurred. This substance involves the collaboration of different personnel, like your rope rescue and what? Extrication personnel. For instance, if you are involved with an operation of a collapse building, or a fire accident. For removal of the victim from a fire accident, the major rescue personnel needed is what? Your firefighting personnel. But for a collapsed building, you need the collaboration of different personnel, like your rope rescue personnel, in case the person is trapped in a confined space in a collapsed building that is needed for people who are specialized in rope rescue, and also your exfiltration personnel. Exfiltration is just the removal of victims or people from a particular area without using the usual means. Like, for instance, the removal of a person from a building, the person needs to go through the door. But in exfiltration, it's a situation where the person is trapped and cannot go through the door. The walls are broken to get the persons out. That can be applied for in your collapsed building, for instance, involves the collaboration of different rescue personnel to carry out this phase. The last is what? Your termination. The termination phase is that phase where the rescue operation gradually comes to an end after the rescue or recovering of the victim has occurred. In this phase, the command team takes time out to perform another risk benefit analysis. What do they mean by termination? As soon as the rescue crew gets there, they'll be able to determine if, from their evaluation, if it's beneficial for them to involve themselves. Remember that one of the major things of rescue operation is saving lives and limiting the number of injuries that has occurred. Now, the rescue personnel are also humans. When carrying out this operation, they will be able to evaluate the risks. If it will endanger them more, that rescue operation will be terminated. Summary: rescue operation is an organized procedure to bring people or a person out of danger, attack, or harm. There are six aspects of rescue operation with the acronym REPORT. Which means response, evaluation, pre-entry, operation, removal, and termination. Let's take some questions. Question 1. The phase of rescue operation that involves evacuation, isolation, and locking out operation is the dash phase. A. Report. B. Pre-entry. C. Evaluation. D. Removal. The answer is B. Pre-entry. Question 2. The rescue operation done based on the information obtained from the risk assessment information is A. Report. B. Pre-entry. C. Operation. D. Evacuation. The answer is C. Operation. We have come to the end of this class and we'll be able to see that there are six aspects of rescue operation with the acronym REPORT. And rescue operation is any operation carried out to get people out of harm and danger. Thank you.